Hello everyone, and welcome back to another Blender Made Easy tutorial. Today I'm going to be showing you how to animate the particles that we created in the last video. In the last video, we rendered out this image here, and now I'll be showing you how to get the particles to move around and act like they're kind of floating in the air. I had a couple comments asking on how to do this, and it's actually pretty simple. So let's go ahead and jump right into it. The first thing that we need to do is change a couple of the settings in the particle system. So go ahead and select your particle system, go over to the particle tab and change it from hair over to emitter. You might notice that everything is now gone. And what we need to do now is set the end frame to 1 so that all of the particles are emitted exactly at the same time. And then also the end frame, I'm going to be setting this to 150. The animation, I want to be 150 frames long, so I'm going to come down here to the timeline and set this to 150 as well. The number of particles, I am going to turn that up to a value of 3000. I think this will look just a little bit better. And you'll also might notice that our size is now a little bit off. We need to go down to the render settings and just turn up the size to match the size that we want. So a value of 0.03 works perfectly fine. I'm going to press Z and go into rendered view to see what this looks like, and then Z toggle overlays. All right, so here is our scene so far. Let's go back into solid view. Now, if we play this animation, we can see that all the particles just fall straight down. The reason for that is because gravity is turned on. Let's open up the field weights down here and turn gravity all the way to 0. I'm also going to open up the velocity, and this normal value is currently set to 1. What this does is it just pushes the particles in a certain direction of their normal, and if I play this, you can see what it does. So right at the start of the animation, all of the particles go in a direction, and that is this normal value here. We need to set this to 0 so the particles stay exactly where they are. Now if I play this, we can see all of our particles are staying in their exact spot, which is good. The next thing that we need to do is get the particles to move around. And a very easy way to do this is to add in a force field. So press Shift A, go to force field, and then add in a turbulence force field. We're going to drag this up into the middle of our scene, and then over here on the strength, we're going to change a couple of settings. First off, if we play this, you can see the particles are moving just way too fast. So I'm going to be setting the strength of this down to a value of 0.1. Now if we restart the animation and play it again, it looks pretty good, but that they are still moving too fast. So I'm going to set the flow value right here to a value of 2. And this just kind of slows down the particles and gets them all moving in a certain direction. And so now if we restart the animation, play it one more time, we can see that looks pretty good. I'm also going to turn up the noise amount, and this will just give everything some more randomness. Let's try a value of 1. We'll restart the animation and play it again. Alright, I'm happy with that. And I think we are ready to do a render. So go ahead and save your project. And we'll click Z and go into rendered view. And then we'll play this in the rendered view to see what it looks like. Not too bad. So if you want your particles to go slower, just turn up the flow amount, or if you want them to go faster, just turn up the strength amount, and you can do something like that. Alright, so now that we are ready to render, let's go over to the render settings. I'm going to set the sampling over here to a value of 40. We don't need to go too high. And then I'll just change the tile size back to 8 pixels. This renders a little bit faster. And I think everything else is good to go. So now that you've done that, go ahead and go over to the output section and set a folder of where you want your images to go to. Once you've found your folder, go ahead and click accept. And now when we do the render, every single frame of our animation will go into that folder. To render an animation, what you need to do is come up to render and click on render animation. And since we're using Eevee, this should only take a couple of minutes. Alright, our render has finished, and now to view it, what we can do is go up to render and click on view animation, and a new window will pop up with your animation playing. And that looks pretty cool. Now what we're going to do is sequence this out. So to do that, we need to open up a new Blender file, so come down to your taskbar and just click on Blender and it will open up a new window. Now with the fresh version of Blender, what we're going to do is go over to this button here, Video Editing, and then Video Editing right here. And we'll open up the Video Sequence Editor. Now we need to import all of those images into this timeline. To do that, click Add, Image Sequence, and then navigate to where your images are. Press A to select everything, and then go Add Image Strip. And here we can see it in our timeline. Now we do need to set the end frame down here, so set this to 150 to match it. And if you use different resolutions in the previous tutorial, make sure you set those resolutions here or it's going to look a little bit stretched. Then of course we need to do the exact same thing with the output, so select an output here. Once you've found your output, go over to the file format and change it to an MPEG. Underneath the encoding, I'm going to set the container to MP4, and then the output quality I'm going to set to high. Once you've done that, go ahead and go up to Render, and then Render Animation. And it will take all of those frames and then put them into a movie file into that folder. Once the render is done, you'll find that movie file in the folder that you specified here, and then you can just double click on it and then view the animation. I was trying to figure out a way to loop the animation seamlessly so we can use it for a background or just something we have text over it or whatever. Unfortunately though, I couldn't figure out a way to make it look good. This is what I came up with, but it doesn't work seamlessly. What I did was I used the image strip right here, I duplicated it and placed it in this on this side, and then I selected this. I made sure that I moved these corners in just by one frame so we don't have duplicate frames. And then I also set the playback direction to be backwards. If I play this though, you can definitely tell that it's a looping animation. Once it reaches there, it just reverses it. So if you guys know a way to make this more seamless, I'd love to hear it, so make sure to tell me in the comments down below. So there you go guys, that is going to be it for this tutorial. Thank you for watching. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe for more tutorials just like this. And if you created your own render or animation, I'd love to see it, so make sure to send it to me over on Instagram. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.